2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
Still lots of colds and flu hanging around as we trek towards the end of winter, and from the Department of Nutrition and Dietetics at the University of Newcastle, Professor Clare Collins is going to take a look at some of the things that we can do to maybe get out of the flus and the bugs and all of that. Good morning, Clare.
Yeah, I thought it was worth talking about, even though we have covered it for Mark, because I had a cold again last week. Thank you, grandchildren.
Oh.
And
are you in the non-contagious stage now? I don't want to get... I've been down that road.
I'm in the non-contagious stage, and I'm also over the conjunctivitis they gave me too. So,
isn't that what everybody says? That, oh, I've passed the contagious stage, I think I'm okay. Yeah.
But it's a timely reminder that the most important thing you can do to stop spreading germs is to wash your hands. Wash your hands and then wash your hands again. And if you've got that hand gel at home, use that too, and take it when you go out so that you can use that frequently.
Well, you could be in a spot where you just can't wash your hands, so it's
get
it on the way you go.
So let's jump in and talk about some of the supplements where there is evidence for them first, and then we'll mention the ones that waste money, may as well leave them on the shelf. Okay. So I was really surprised when I looked at the evidence for things called probiotics. And there actually is some evidence that they can shorten the length of a cold. So it still might be bad, but you know, they're definitely worth taking. So the most common ones, easy to find on the supermarket shelf, are in the yogurt aisle. And there are some that are sold as like shots, like probiotic shots. And just look for ones that say they've got live culture in them. But here's the trick with them. They're more effective if there's more bacteria in them. And so it's the longer the shelf life. So reach down the back and grab the ones that have a longer time to the use by.
Just like when you're buying milk, you always look for the ones that got that extra couple of days on.
Yeah, well, I think that's definitely worth trying. Good source of nutrients as well. And often people don't buy milk products because they think, oh, milk makes mucus. But someone did an experiment on that and it doesn't. The reason why your mouth gets thick after you drink milk or eat yogurt is because the digestive enzymes start linking all the proteins together. And it's just a protein thickness, like when you make custard and the skin comes to the top.
So it's really just part of the process.
Yeah, absolutely. The other one there actually is some evidence for, but is zinc. Most of the studies, the zinc is taken as lozenges, but only at the very start of a cold. So you've got to get onto it within the first 24 hours of a cold. And it's a huge whopping dose. It's 75 milligrams, which is like a whole week's needs in one go. So particularly if you have other illnesses, I think zinc is worth trying.
So if we need that massive amount, how would we be able to get that amount of
you actually have to take a supplement for the zinc. You could get it by a few dozen oysters, but it's probably cheaper to buy the supplement in that case.
Definitely the supplement.
Yeah. Then there's no evidence for garlic. You know, there's one tiny study and it's a bit dodgy. There's no evidence for echinacea either, and there's no evidence, believe it or not, for actually vitamin C. And the thing about the vitamin C is you have to take 200 milligrams every single day, and there was like a reduction of less than half a day for a cold, but it's not worth taking because it increases your risk for getting kidney stones. Two exceptions. If you're a cold weather, you work in cold weather, like you work at the ski fields, or people who have chronic lung disease where they're really at high risk for developing pneumonia, then for winter, it's probably worth them being on vitamin C.
But of course, we don't have any of that here, so different story.
No, that's right. Then there's one that's a really good news story, and that's chicken soup. Someone did an experiment that showed that some things in chicken soup can help boost your immune system, that just having chicken soup makes you feel good because of all the memories. And another one in 15 volunteers, they showed that chicken soup makes your nose run more than just having a drink of water or a cold soup or something else.
Okay, so that's probably a good thing, but the rest, mind over matter with the soup.
Yeah, well, even if it's a placebo effect, and also there's something comforting about having something that your mum gave you to help you feel better. So, you know, whether that's another kind of soup, then jump in and have a go at that. And then one other little thing, if you're feeling so bad that you need to take a Panadol or Nurofen or something like that, it actually works better if you have it with a cup of tea or coffee, and the caffeine in it potentiates the effect of the pain relieving.
So do that with your favourite hot brew instead of a glass of water, maybe.
Yeah, even if it is a soup. And at the moment, like red capsicums and tomatoes are pretty cheap, so you could make your own homemade tomato soup by roasting up a big tray, couple of red onions, a litre of salt-reduced chicken stock, a spoon of garlic, and a bit of spices that you like, whiz it up, and that is actually a really nice warming soup that'll help make your nose run.
And very tasty. Not a bad place to end. Clare Collins, as always, thank you so much for your time.
Yeah, pleasure.
To NURFM 103.7.